الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما أخرجنا من ظلمات الوهم وأكرمنا بنور الفهم وأنعم علينا يا عظيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي اما بعد All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and peace be upon his beloved prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I testify that there is no god except Allah and I testify that Muhammad is the prophet and the messenger of Allah. My brothers and sisters in Islam, as we left you with a fortnight ago, speaking about this great prophet, a great example for all men and women, especially the youth. It's the Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned his story in the Holy Quran, and his whole story came as one chapter, one surah. No story like the story of Yusuf came all together in one place as the story of Yusuf came. And we mentioned how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Yusuf alayhi salam from a young age. A young age, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open the doors of piety to Yusuf alayhi salam. Knowing that Yusuf is the son of a prophet, the grandson of a prophet, the grandson of the prophet. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned him by saying, Al-Kareem, Ibn al-Kareem, Ibn al-Kareem, Ibn al-Kareem, the generous man, the son of the generous man, the son of the generous man, the son of the generous man, Yusuf, the son of Yaqub, and Yaqub is Israel, the son of Ishaq, the son of Ibrahim, alayhim afdal as-salam. And we mentioned how the brothers of Yusuf had a lot of hasad and envy towards their brother because of the attention that his father used to give to him. And then his brothers plotted against Yusuf and deceived their father by saying that they want to take him out for some outing and some fun. And they threw Yusuf alayhi salam in a well. And they came back lying to their father saying that the wolf came and ate him. And we mentioned how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected Yusuf and saved him. And then he was sold to the treasurer of Egypt, and his name in the Quran is the Aziz. And the treasurer is the second most powerful man. Usually in governments, the treasurer is considered to be the second most powerful man. And at that time, the treasurer, the Aziz, was indeed the second most powerful man after the king, after the Malik. And Yusuf alayhi salam, he grew up in that household. And we mentioned how the wife of the treasurer, she was happy to keep Yusuf in her household because the treasurer himself was barren. He could not get kids and his wife could not fall pregnant. So she mentioned this kid can be a way or another of having a child or benefit out of him. And Yusuf alayhi salam will grow up where? In the house of the treasurer, growing up a luxury life. Although he was a slave, but he was a slave for a treasurer. He was a slave for one of the most wealthiest people at that time. And then the big test comes to Yusuf alayhi salam. Before that test, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَلَمَّا بَلَغَ أَشُدَّهُ آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. When Yusuf alayhi salam reached his age, the age of prime, and some scholars disagree over what age was Yusuf then. Was it the age of maturity? Or is it the age of the prophecy, as most prophets, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sends the message of prophecy to them in the late 30s and or early 40s. Some scholars say he was 20, other scholars say 25, Allahu A'lam, but he's around the age, the young age. Yusuf alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that he reached to the prime age. He became now mature, fit, strong, and pious. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open the doors of prophecy to him, in which Allah Almighty will reveal to him. And we know the prophets, they get revealed to them by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the wahi that we speak about. And Allah Azza wa Jal gave Yusuf alayhi salam the great knowledge, not only the worldly knowledge, but also the spiritual knowledge, the hereafter knowledge, as the scholars describe it to be. And now becomes the big test on Yusuf alayhi salam. Adding over all this, not only that Yusuf alayhi salam was mature, a young man, righteous, pious, God-fearing, and knowledgeable, but Yusuf alayhi salam was a so beautiful looking person, so handsome, that the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam said, when he went on the journey of Mi'raj and he went past Yusuf alayhi salam, he said, by Allah, he's given half of the beauty. Half of the beauty. And the scholars described that as to be that Allah Azza wa Jal created two beauties, one for the whole world and the other for Yusuf alayhi salam. That's how beautiful he was, and that's how handsome and beautiful looking Yusuf alayhi salam used to be. And someone in that position, someone with that looking, he's open to big tests. And the test took place in the place that he's living. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَرَاوَدَتْهُ الَّتِي هُوَ فِي بَيْتِهَا عَنْ نَفْسِهِ وَغَلَّقَتِ الْأَبْوَابِ. Allah Almighty, he's mentioning that the wife of the treasurer, and some scholars name her as to be Zulaykha, the wife of the treasurer, seeing Yusuf living around her with the beautiful looking and handsome looking, it's not something that a natural woman can grab herself from not falling into the wrong or the haram. And she saw and planned and plotted for the best time for her to fulfill her desire. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, and she plotted, the one in her house, she plotted against Yusuf alayhi salam. وغلقت الأبواب. She looked for the perfect moment for her to fulfill her desires. And waited where most of his slaves were away. Her own husband was away. And she prepared the perfect room in the perfect moment, in the perfect timing, and she closed the doors. She called Yusuf alayhi salam and she closed the doors. And she got ready for Yusuf. She thought Yusuf alayhi salam is like the average person out there. He'll get deceived for such and doesn't fear anyone. Especially when no one is around. She thought that maybe Yusuf is that type. But Yusuf knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching him. So she got ready for Yusuf. And she wore her best clothes. And she put her perfume and her makeup. And she waited for the perfect moment and called Yusuf and closed the doors. And then she tells him, Hayta lak, come close. Come close. Let's do the fahsha, let's do the wrong. Let's do what a husband does with his wife or a wife does with her husband. And who is she calling? She's calling a prophet. She's not calling an average man. She's not calling an average Muslim, an average believer. She is calling a prophet, a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who really indeed fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what was the response that she was expecting from Yusuf? Is yes. But Yusuf said, Ma'ad Allah. Ma'ad Allah, I'll seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No way. No way such an action will be accepted from someone like myself. And who's watching Yusuf at that time? No one. Except Allah. Who will go out and speak about Yusuf? But Yusuf knows, if I'm embarrassed from people, I should be embarrassed from Allah, the Lord of people. And this is the belief and the faith that every Muslim, every teenager must have in their heart. That if not only if people not around, I can commit the corruption or the evil, but I should always remember that Allah is watching me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching me. So she told him, Hayta lak, come forward, O Yusuf. Yusuf said, Ma'ad Allah. Innahu Rabbi ahsana mathwai. Innahu la yiflihu al-zalimun. No way. A'udhu billah. This is absolutely wrong. I would not accept such a thing. This is against the orders of my Lord. This is against the orders of my religion. This is against the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not only that. What did Yusuf say? Innahu Rabbi ahsana mathwai. Your husband, the treasurer. And Rabb in Arabic, my brothers and sisters in Islam, means the owner. So when Yusuf alayhi salam said Rabbi, he's referring to his owner, he's referring to the owner of the house, which is the treasurer. He's saying, you are his wife, and your husband was good to me. I can't betray him and do something like that. Regardless, or not just only because I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but also your husband is the one that looked after me. I can't go behind his back and do something like this, especially to his wife. This is disrespect. Innahu Rabbi ahsana mathwai. Innahu la yiflihu al-zalimun. Those who will oppress, those who are oppressors will never succeed. And someone to do such an action, especially against the will and the, or against the orders of his Lord, and also against his own master, or against his own master, the one that looked after him, this is oppression. I should pay my master with good, not with bad. This is not what my master expects from me. Ma'ad Allah. And that's why, my brothers and sisters, the scholars always mention as an example of the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that seven Allah will shade under his shade. When there's no shade except his shade, and one of them is a man that a pretty or a beautiful woman called him for the haram, and he said, I fear Allah. I fear Allah. This is how the Muslim should be, and this is where the teenagers, every Muslim youth, should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And before you get embarrassed from any human being, be embarrassed from Allah Almighty, the one that's watching you. And there is a famous story of a Bedouin man who fell in love with this Bedouin woman. And this Bedouin woman, she used to fear Allah Azza wa Jal. So one day this Bedouin man, he followed and spied on this Bedouin woman, waiting for the right moment to have with her what her husband has with his wife. And one night this Bedouin woman will walk out for her necessity, for the call of a necessary natural call in the middle of the night, and he'll follow her. And he'll say, now it's the perfect time and moment for me to have from you what her husband has with his wife. So she said to him, Then go and look and make sure that everyone is asleep. So he went to the tent and he saw everyone asleep. He came back so happy. He said, no, it's the perfect opportunity. Everyone is asleep. Everyone is unaware. So she told him, then go and make sure that Allah is asleep. Go and make sure that Allah is asleep and he's not aware. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. He is the one that does not get fatigued or tired, nor that any sleep or any of our human nature applies on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُ رَبِّي أَحْسَنَ مَثْوَيْ. But this woman, the wife of the treasurer, she's a woman, she's not on the right path. She wants to fulfill her desire. And a lot of people in that position of wealth, and a lot of people, and I don't say all, but many of them, and vast majority, they get too deceived with the dunya and the materialistic life and wealth. They just follow their desires and do whatever their desires call them for without any principles, without any religion or faith. So she insisted. She insisted of deceiving Yusuf alayhi salam, for Yusuf alayhi salam to submit to her will, to submit to her desires. And Yusuf refused. And not only refused, he refused with no hesitance. Maybe someone refused with a bit of hesitance. Yusuf alayhi salam refused with no hesitance. I would not give or take this pleasure and lose the pleasure of the hereafter. This is how you have to think, my brother. And this is how you have to think, my sister. Don't sell your hereafter for something little of this dunya. It's not worth it. By Allah, it is not worth it. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا لَوْلَا أَنْ رَأَى بُرْهَانَ رَبِّهِ. She verily desired him, as Allah Azza wa Jalla says. She was very deceiving. She was insisting on Yusuf alayhi salam to submit to her. And he also insisted to keep away from her. وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا. Some scholars interpret that verse in a wrong way. They say, he also thought of her. By Allah, he did not think of her. He is a prophet. And prophets and messengers do not commit evil, nor they think of evil. She desired him, وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا. And he also insisted not to go near her. لَوْلَا أَرَّأَى بُرْهَانَ رَبِّهِ. And no doubt, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had shown him. He's a prophet, he's a messenger. Allah had shown him what an average man or person or believer doesn't see. Allah Azza wa Jal had shown him. Allah Azza wa Jal had revealed to him where no average man or human being gets revealed to. So no doubt a prophet and a messenger has that strength. Not only because they are prophets and messengers, because they also see things that we don't see. It's enough that it's enough Allah Azza wa Jal reveals to them. It's enough that they know from themselves that are responsible as leaders in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَذَلِكَ لِنَصْرِفَ عَنْهُ السُّوءَ وَالْفَحْشَاءَ إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, and this is to keep away the evilness and the wrongdoings from Yusuf. And this is the case with all prophets and messengers. All prophets and messengers have something called isma, and the isma means sinless. They do not commit sins, nor they think of committing sins. All the prophets and messengers, Allah had given them something called isma. They do not fall into the sins or evil doings. And then Allah says, إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. He is from the chosen slaves of ours. مُخْلَصِين. مُخْلَص means chosen. مُخْلَص means sincere. Allah Azza wa Jal describes Yusuf alayhi salam as being the chosen one by Allah. And then what did she do? When she saw Yusuf alayhi salam, no way he'll give up. And every time she comes near him, he'll walk away from her. But where's he going to go? The doors are locked. If the doors were open, he would have ran out of that door. But every time she comes near him, he'll go to a different place, different corner, and she's chasing Yusuf alayhi salam. And he'll go from one place and she'll chase him and she's trying to deceive him. She's trying to manipulate him. And Yusuf insisting, no, 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 by Allah, I would not disobey my Lord. I would not disobey my Lord. And Yusuf alayhi salam is running away from her. And while he's running away from her, she is chasing him and she grabbed his back. She grabbed his shirt from his back. And Yusuf alayhi salam is running away from her. So she ripped his shirt from the back. And while this is taking place, who walks in? Her husband. وَاسْتَبَقَ الْبَابَ وَقَدَّتْ قَمِيسَهُ مِنْ دُبُرْ وَأَلْفَ يَا سَيِّدَهَا لَدَ الْبَابِ When she did that, by a sudden, unexpected time, the treasurer, her husband, Yusuf's master, walks in. وَاسْتَبَقَ الْبَابَ وَقَدَّتْ قَمِيسَهُ مِنْ دُبُرْ وَأَلْفَ يَا سَيِّدَهَا لَدَ الْبَابِ When she saw that scene, she got caught. She got caught by her husband. What is she going to say? Straight away, she twisted the story.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose whom He wills subhanahu wa ta'ala for His mercy, for His messengership, for the revelation to be revealed. This is not for the human beings to make that decision. If a person would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely, truthfully, asking for forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised to forgive. We have as Muslims a duty, and that is to recite the book of Allah, to ponder over the verses, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to act according to the Quran. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything, but it who would this mercy will be for? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent to all mankind. So the ummah, or the people of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, are all mankind since the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam till the day of judgment. Why waste our life without getting to know every verse in the Quran, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us?
Story, so she could clear herself in front of her husband. What did she say? قالت ما جزاء من أراد بأهلك سوءا إلا أن يسجن أو عذاب أليم. She said, what would you do to someone who's trying to harm your family? What would you do to someone who's trying to attack your own wife? This man here, this slave over here, this man of yours is trying to attack me. He's trying to get from me what a husband gets from his wife. This man here, he's trying to do his harm towards your family. What would you do to him? And she was smart. She did not say. What did she say? She said, the only punishment that you must punish him is to lock him up or punish him a severe punishment. The scholars say, why did she mention the punishment herself? She was afraid that her husband would end up killing Yusuf alayhi salam. And that's maybe a bit too hard for her conscience to accept. So she mentioned the punishment herself. Lock him up or just punish him. Whip him, lash him, do whatever. So she takes away the thought of his mind, away from his mind, the thought of killing Yusuf alayhi salam. But Yusuf alayhi salam, he's seeing that scene. He's not going to keep quiet. He spoke out. He said, قَالَ هِيَ رَاوَدَتْنِي عَنْ نَفْسِي She is the one that tried to attack me. She is the one that asked me for this evil act. She is the one that's been chasing me and I'm running away from her. As because I fear my Lord and respect for you. قَالَ هِيَ رَاوَدَتْنِي عَنْ نَفْسِي وَشَهِدَ شَاهِدٌ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا But Yusuf alayhi salam, who's going to witness for him? The treasurer is going to take his wife's word over Yusuf's word. He's not going to take Yusuf's word over his wife's. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a miracle take place. In that room, the treasurer's wife, she had one of her cousin's baby. A young baby, still in the clot, still young, baby age, doesn't speak, can't move. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَشَهِدَ شَاهِدٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِهَا, and a witness from her own family witnessed against her. The scholars say it was that baby that Allah made this baby speak against her for Yusuf alayhi salam. This baby spoke against her for Yusuf alayhi salam. And this is the majority interpretation of the scholars. Other scholars have a different opinion in which they say it was a slave who comes from her family. But most of them say it was a baby still young, can't speak, can't move, can't take care of itself. Allah Azza wa Jal made that baby speak out for Yusuf alayhi salam against him. And what did he say? In kana qamisu qudda min qubulin fasadaqat wa huwa min al-kadhibin wa in kana qamisu qudda min duburin fakadhabat wa huwa min as-sadiqin. He said, if his shirt was ripped from front, then she is saying the truth and he is the liar. He would have ripped to himself. But if his shirt is ripped from behind, then he is saying the truth and she is the liar. Because how can he rip his shirt from behind? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, فَلَمَّا رَأَى قَمِيسَ قُدَّ مِن دُبُرٍ قَالَ إِنَّهُ مِن كَيْدِكُنْ إِنَّ كَيْدَكُنَّ عَظِيمٌ. When the treasurer, her husband, saw that the shirt of Yusuf was ripped behind, it was ripped from behind, and common sense, well, how was Yusuf going to reach from behind his back to rip his shirt? He realized he is saying the truth, and she is the liar. And he said, إِنَّهُ مِن كَيْدِكُنْ إِنَّ كَيْدَكُنَّ عَظِيمٌ. This is from your evil plotting, O woman. This is from your evil plotting. Your plotting is indeed a great evil. That's why he told his wife. And then, you're talking about a treasurer, some politician up there. All they care about is themselves and their status. And nature, I don't say all, but the nature of people in that position don't have much honor. They don't have that jealousy towards their wives or families. Not all, as I mentioned, but vast majority of that way of thinking and that type of people who are always in the high status of politics and high status of wealth don't have honor or jealousy towards their family. What do you expect from someone like this type of person, the treasurer, hearing that his own wife was going behind his back to be with a slave in their eyes? Another normal person, he'll end up doing something much bigger. So what did he say? He said, Yusuf a'rad an hadha. Oh Yusuf, keep quiet over what happened. Don't embarrass me and embarrass my family. And what did he do to his wife? He said, wastaghfiri li dhanbiki innaki kunti min al-khati'in. You should repent and ask forgiveness for what you did. This is the wrongdoings. And that's it, closed. Wallah, if it was an Arab, it would have killed her and killed the one next to her and the one that's standing there and anyone that says anything. But this is their nature. He just said, Yusuf, keep quiet, don't say anything, continue doing and live your normal life. And he told her, you did something wrong. You did something wrong. Okay, it's like, you know, she spent $10 without approval or something. Okay, you did something wrong, you should repent, and that's it, finish. This is the type of people. But it did not end there. Yusuf alayhi salam, you're talking about a prophet and a messenger, he kept quiet. It's not something good for him. But there was other slaves who heard the conversation. There's a lot of slaves in that palace, in that house. Talking about a treasurer. He's got a massive palace, many slaves there. So they start to hear. And they heard what's happened. And those slaves, because they're on a low class of people, they speak out. Maybe they speak out for the sake of getting money. And they went and spread the rumor around. Went and spread the news to everyone. And the word went around. And not only around, but even went the word went around to the closest people, to the treasurer's family, the other ministers' wives, the other rich people, and the gossip started. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَقَالَ نِسْوَةٌ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ امْرَأَةُ الْعَزِيزِ تُرَاوِدُ فَتَاهَا عَنْ نَفْسِهِ قَدْ شَغَفَهَا حُبَّ إِنَّ لَنَرَاهَا فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. A group of women got together, the wives of the other ministers, the wives of the other rich people. You know, the class, at that time there's all these different class. You're talking about the highest class of people, the richest and the most strongest people. Their wives were sitting down together one day, and they were talking. They were talking about the action of the treasurer's wife. They're saying, what kind of a woman is she? She goes out of all men. She goes and chases her own slave. How low is this woman? Out of all men, she'll go behind a slave. She is a woman that, she's unbalanced. She's crazy. Her love towards that slave looks like beyond the joke. And then they said, "Inna lanaraha fi dalalin mubin." We could see this woman indeed, a very lost woman. She's crazy. She's in lust. She's astray. So the treasurer's wife, when she heard of that, you know, gossip goes around from woman to this woman to that woman. The news came to her that people speaking about her and about what she attempted to do with her own slave. So she wanted to prove everyone wrong. She wanted to show them that what she did was out of her nature, because this man, Yusuf alayhi salam, he is extremely too good looking person. And she invited those women over. فَلَمَّا سَمِعَتْ بِمَكْرِهِنْ, when she heard about their gossip and their talk, أَرْسَلَتْ إِلَيْهِنْ وَاعْتَدَتْ لَهُنَّ مُتَّكَأً وَآتَتْ كُلَّ وَاحِدَةٍ مِّنْهُنَّ سِكِّينًا. She organized a day out, you know, the subhiyya. The women get together in the morning, some gathering. She called all those women over because they're all her friends. She prepared a nice a'da, a nice session. All of them sitting down, and she got fruits. And she didn't get any fruits, she got fruits that needs peeling, she needs cutting. And she got them knives to peel the fruits. And while they were sitting down speaking, she got Yusuf to wear his best of clothes. And Yusuf alayhi salam doesn't know the plotting and the planning that she is planning. And while they are sitting down laughing, smiling, eating the fruits, she'll call and order Yusuf to come in. So the door opens and Yusuf walks in. They stop and look at Yusuf. They forgot everything around them. Allah Azza wa Jalla describes that scene and says, وَقَالَتْ اُخْرُجْ عَلَيْهِنْ, O Yusuf, come and appear to them. فَلَمَّا رَأَيْنَهُ, when they saw him, أَكْبَرْنَهُ, wow, this is much greater, he's much better looking than what we expected. This is not the expectation. We heard he's good looking, but not to this extreme. And they said, وَقُلْنَا حَاشَ لِلَّهِ, by Allah, this is not normal. مَا هَذَا بَشَرٌ, he's not a human being. إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا مَلَكٌ كَرِيمٌ, he's a gracious angel. This is an angel. This is not a human being in front of us. This is an angel in front of us. And Allah says, وَقَطَّعْنَا أَيْدِيَهُنْ, and while they were looking and being stunned and shocked in the appearance of Yusuf, they were cutting their fingers instead of the fruits. And they did not even feel in it. Just stunned, shocked, amazed. Allah describes that scene in the Quran Kareem, how amazed they were when they looked at Yusuf. This is not a normal human being. This is not a human being at all. This is an angel from the heaven. How beautiful is he? And they were so shocked. Instead of peeling the fruits, they were just peeling their hands and fingers off without them realizing. They were just in a different world. And now Yusuf alayhi salam doesn't have one trouble, not only double trouble, but triple trouble. From one woman chasing him, all those women now are after him. قالت فذلكن الذي لمتنني فيه. Zulaykha, the treasurer's wife, she's smart. She told him, huh? Is this why you've been speaking about me? Look at Yusuf now. Look at Yusuf now. You're blaming me? You're trying to put the fingers on me? Look at Yusuf now. Now you know where I come from. You were talking about me and degrading me in front of everyone that I couldn't grab myself. It looks like the same thing with you and every other woman. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَلَقَدْ رَاوَتُهُ عَن نَفْسِهِ فَاسْتَعْصَمْ. And she was a very tough woman, Zulaykha, she said. And the truth is, yes, I wanted him for myself. I tried to get him for myself. I wanted to do what everyone's talking about out there. But he refused. فَاسْتَعْصَمْ. He refused. And then she said, وَلَئِنْ لَمْ يَفْعَلْ مَا أَمُرُهُ لَيُسْجَنَنَّ وَلَيَكُونَ مِنَ الصَّاغِرِينَ. And I'm telling him, in front of you all, if he does not do what I want him to do, in other words, I did not forget what I wanted to do from, I'm still insisting to do with him what I wanted to do. If he does not do what I am ordering to do, I'm going to lock him up and I'm going to degrade him in front of everyone. And now everyone is agreeing with her. The other ladies, Ma'akha, you've got the rights. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, Allah Azza wa Jal then mentions in the Quran al-Kareem, look at Yusuf alayhi salam after he saw this. Wallah, ikhwani, an average teenager these days dreams of such a moment. Woman around, every woman is dying for me. Having this woman, having that woman, excuse me for this, but this is the reality. All teenagers are thinking of this, and that's why boys, their mind is taken away with girls, and girls, their mind is taken away with boys. The unfortunate thing is, someone thinks, an average teenager just dreams of that moment. And what did Yusuf alayhi salam say? This is a true mu'min, a prophet and a messenger from Allah. When he saw that scene, these people want the evil from me, I'm not going to let this go. I'll never disobey my Lord. I would never give my honor away for such desire. He said, قَالَ رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيَّ. When she said, I will lock him up, he said, Ya Rab, prison and lock up for me is much better than what they're calling me for. I'd rather be locked up, being oppressed, being punished, but not disobey my Lord. Who thinks like this, my brothers? Who thinks like this, my sisters? I would rather be punished. I would rather be locked up. I would rather be beaten than disobeying my Lord. People sell their religion these days. I'll sell my religion for a woman, and I'll sell my religion for a man, and I'll sell my religion for a dollar, and I'll sell my religion for $10, and I'll sell my religion for anything of this dunya. And Yusuf says, oh my Lord, I would rather be locked up. Lock up is more beloved to me than what they're calling me for. قَالَ رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيَّ. Oh my Lord, prison and lock up is more beloved to me than this fahsha they're calling me for. And then he says, وَإِلَّا تَصْرِفْ عَنِّي كَيْدَهُنَّ أَصْبُ إِلَيْهِنَّ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ. Oh Allah, I ask you to keep away from me their plotting and evil doings, or else أَكُمْ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ, I'll be from the foolish and ignorant ones. I don't want to be in that level. I want to stay high with Allah Azza wa Jal. I want to keep my iman high. I would not give anything. I would not give anything away from my deen for the sake of this dunya. I would not disobey my Lord. This is something we need to understand. Allah Azza wa Jal says, فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ فَصَرَفَ عَنْهُ كَيْدَهُنْ إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Allah says, his Lord heard him. And Allah Azza wa Jal says, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his dua. He said, Ya Allah, I'd rather be locked up than being in that position. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his dua. And Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the means and ways for him to be locked up. إِنَّهُ وَالسَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla says, ثُمَّ بَدَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا رَأُوا الْآيَاتِ لَا يَسْجُنُنَّهُ حَتَّى حِينَ. When Yusuf alayhi salam, not only this time he refused Zulaykha, the treasurer's wife, but he's refusing all those women and every other woman that she is not permitted for him Islamically. He refused them all. He said, I'd rather be locked up. And of course, being permitted to him Islamically is his wife. Or beside that, he refused them all. So when he refused them all, they locked him up. But that wasn't only the way. These women realized that the news later on would go out on them the same it went out on Zulaykha, the treasurer's wife. So the treasurer's wife sat down with her husband, the treasurer, second most powerful man in Egypt. And she plotted and planned with him. She said, listen, the fadiha, the embarrassment is going to reach everywhere. If you don't lock up Yusuf, and not only locking up Yusuf, but I'm afraid if you lock up Yusuf without doing anything else, people will start thinking that because Yusuf refused committing the action with us or with me, he got locked up. We need to prove to everyone that it was Yusuf the one that was trying to do the wrongdoing. Not me, I'm the treasurer's wife. You don't want to get this embarrassment. So they planned and plotted. And then they came up with a suggestion and solution. And it was acted on Yusuf alayhi salam. Yusuf alayhi salam, he was put on a donkey in the opposite direction. And this is one of the ways that humiliate someone. Instead of riding the donkey the right way, they put him the reverse way, means humiliation. And he ordered people to grab the drums and walk in the middle of the streets of Egypt, beating the drums and saying that Yusuf, the slave of the treasurer, will be locked up because he tried to go near the treasurer's wife. And kept on going around the streets of Egypt, humiliating Yusuf alayhi salam. Yusuf, the slave of the treasurer, will be locked up because of the crime that he had committed, trying to get near the treasurer's wife. Humiliating Yusuf alayhi salam. What an embarrassment, my brothers. Who could handle this? But Yusuf alayhi salam, for the sake of Allah, handled this. And that's why my brothers in Islam, don't be embarrassed if it's upholding the deen of Allah. Some people are embarrassed to pray in the public. People will look at me. Some people are embarrassed to wear the hijab. People will think of me this. Don't be embarrassed of your deen. Be firm and strong. Be firm and strong. And Allah Azza wa Jalla will always prefer the haqq. And then Yusuf alayhi salam was locked up. Locked up for what? For being modest. Locked up for what? For being respectful. Locked up for what? For respecting and having loyalty towards his master, the treasurer. That's why he was locked up. And this is the truth, my brothers and sisters. Many times the truth is fought against. And people will see the truth as the false, and the false is truth. But at the end of the day, the truth will arise and demolish the false. And that's what happened with Yusuf alayhi salam. When he entered the prison, two others walked into the prison with him. Allah Azza wa says, وَدَخَلَ مَعَهُ السِّجْنَ فَتَيَانِ. Two young men walked into prison with him. They were locked up. Those two men, they were slaves working for the king. They were slaves working for the king. One used to work in the bakery of the king. Used to make bread for him. And the other one used to be the one that fills up the cup of wine for the king. And the king heard something about him. He was suspicious about them two doing something, stealing something, trying to plot something. So he locked them up. And those two lived in the same cell with Yusuf alayhi salam. 24 hours in the same place as Yusuf. They see Yusuf alayhi salam, his piety, his manners, his akhlaq, his prayers, his high spirit. They were amazed. They've never experienced someone like this in their life, especially at that time. This person has great connections. So they had this respect for Yusuf alayhi salam. And one night, they saw a dream. One of them, he saw that he was squeezing grapes to turn it to wine. He was squeezing grapes to turn it to wine in a bucket that all the squeeze of the wine, or the squeeze of the grapes came in. قَالَ أَحَدُهُمَا إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَعْصِرُ خَمْرًا. He was squeezing grapes for wine. وَقَالَ الْآخَرُ إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَحْمِلُ فَوْقَ رَأْسِي خُبْزًا تَأْكُلُ الطَّيْرُ مِنْ. The other one said, I also saw a maze dream. The next day they sat down and they were amazed from what they saw. So this first person, which was the one that used to fill up the cup of wine for the king, he saw in the dreams they were squeezing wine, grapes, squeezing them for wine for the, he's squeezing them as wine. The other one, the bakery, the one that used to work in the bakery, he saw in his dreams that he was carrying a basket of wheat, of bread, and birds were coming and eating from it. So when they saw the piety of Yusuf alayhi salam, they the next morning told Yusuf the story and they told him, look, we could see you as one of the righteous people. Inna lanaka min al-muhsinin. We'll see you as from the good people. And you could probably have a good interpretation for the dream that we saw. So the first one told him, I saw in the dreams that was squeezing wine. The other one said, I saw in the dreams that was carrying a basket of wheat or bread. And the birds were coming and eating from it. So Yusuf alayhi salam, he said, قَالَ لَا يَأْتِيكُمَا طَعَامٌ تُرْزَقَانِهِ إِلَّا نَبَّأْتُكُمَا بِتَأْوِيلِهِ قَبْلَ أَن يَأْتِيَكُمَا. There are prisoners. And of course they get food. Who gets the food for them? Oh, the police or the security or the soldiers or whoever's taking care of the prison. And of course they get different food every here and then. Yusuf alayhi salam wanted to tell them the interpretation. And Yusuf alayhi salam wants to tell them that the interpretation that I will tell you about your dream is true and real. And this knowledge of mine is not coming from my personal theory or my personal knowledge, is coming from Allah. But for him to convince them that what he's saying is from Allah, he told them another thing. He said, you know, the food that will come to you, I'm going to tell you exactly what type of food will come to you. And you'll see I am correct. So you don't doubt me when I say the other thing, when I interpret your dreams, I'll be indeed correct. قَالَ لَا يَأْتِيكُمَا طَعَامٌ تُرْزَقَانِهِ إِلَّا نَبَّأْتُكُمَا بِتَأْوِيلِ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمَا. Today you'll be eating such food. And then the food came exactly what Yusuf said, exactly what came. So they were amazed. Now they've got full more trust in Yusuf, that when Yusuf is going to interpret the dreams to them, they're going to listen. And before Yusuf alayhi salam interpreted the dream, he called them to Allah. He said, ذَلِكُمَا مِمَّا عَلَّمَنِي رَبِّي. This is the knowledge of my Lord. It's Allah Azza wa Jal, my Lord, the one that taught me this. It's not coming from me. I am nothing. I have absolutely nothing. I'm weak. I've got nothing. It's all from my Lord Allah Azza wa Jal. إِنِّي تَرَكْتُ مِلَّةَ قَوْمٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَهُمْ بِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ كَافِرُونَ. I left people who don't believe in Allah. They don't believe in Allah. They don't worship Allah. They are disbelievers. وَاتَّبَعْتُ مِلَّةَ أَبَاي. I followed the path, the religion of my forefathers, Ibrahim, wa Ishaq, wa Yaqub. They are my forefathers, the old prophets and messengers. They followed one religion, that religion called Islam. That religion called Islam and not other religion except Islam. مَا كَانَ لَنَا أَن نُشْرِكَ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. We have no rights to associate anyone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذَلِكَ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْنَا. All this, and the knowledge that you see from me, it's all from Allah. It's a favor and a gift from Allah, ni'mah from Allah. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. And many people, أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرُونَ. Many people don't thank Allah Azza wa Jal for it. And then he said, يَا صَاحِبَي السِّجْنِ أَأَرْبَابٌ مُتَفَرِّقُونَ خَيْرٌ أَمِ اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَّارِ. They used to be idol worshippers. And there's so many idols they worship. So he said, all my friends, all my self friends, for you to worship many gods, separated in all different areas, better or worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty the One? Which one is better? Worship Allah Azza wa Jal. You're worshipping all these different lords. And you're running behind. When you want water, you go to this one. When you want rizq, you go to that one. When you want kids, you go to this one. Well, my Lord is one. He's got everything in His hands. Which one is better? He said, مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِهِ إِلَّا أَسْمَاءً سَمَّيْتُمُهَا. These gods and lords that you are worshipping, it's only names. Only names that you brought them up. Don't even exist. You made them up. They should worship you instead of you worshipping them. You made them with your own hands. أنتم وأباؤكم, you and your fathers, ما أنزل الله بها من سلطان. There is absolutely no evidence where these idols came from. إن الحكم إلا لله. The judgments to Allah and only Allah. أمر ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه, and your Lord had ordered you to worship Him and no one but Him. ذلك الدين القيم. This is the straight religion. The clear religion, one straight path, Islam. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ, and most people don't know. And then, after he gave him the da'wah and preached to him, he said, يَا صَاحِبَ يَسِجْ, now I'll tell you what's the interpretation. أَمَّا أَحَدُكُمَا فَيَسْقِي رَبَّهُ خَمْرًا. The one that saw in his dreams that he was squeezing wine, and he was what originally used to fill up the cup of wine for his master or the king. He said, the interpretation of your dream squeezing wine, you're going to go back to your job. You're going to be freed and you're going to go back to your job. وَأَمَّا الْآخَرُ فَيُسْلَبُ فَتَأْكُلُ الطَّيْرُ مِنْ رَأْسِهِ. The other one that saw, he was carrying a basket of wheat and bread and birds coming from all over the place eating it. He said, you'll be crucified and killed, and birds will come and eat from your flesh while you're dead. One is going to be out and the other one's going to be locked. Please change the whole interpretation, change the channel. So the start were amazed. Of course the one that's going to be survived, he's over the moon. But the other one, of course he's not happy. So he started to argue. But, you know, he probably, Allah Alam probably came out and wanted to change the interpretation. No, I didn't say, I was just making it up. So Yusuf alayhi salam said, قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ الَّذِي فِيهِ تَسْتَفْتِيَنْ. That's it. It's closed. Case closed. There's no turning back. And what happened? Exactly what Yusuf alayhi salam said, exactly what happened. Why shouldn't it be exactly if that knowledge is from Allah? All came from Allah Azza wa Jal, not from Yusuf. So the one that saw in the dreams who was squeezing wine, who was released and went back to his old job. And the one that saw in his dreams that was carrying a basket of bread and the birds were eating from it, he was found guilty and was crucified. He was killed on the cross, and the bird came and ate from his flesh. And before the one that survived, the one that saw in the dreams that he was squeezing wine and he went back to his old job, what did Yusuf say to him? اذكرني عند ربك. وقال الذي ظن أنه ناج منهما اذكرني عند ربك. When he went, he told him, listen, by the way, mention me in front of your king. Tell him about me and the reason that I'm here. I'm an innocent man. Of course, no one likes to be in a prison. No one likes to be in the prison. Whether you're a prophet or not, you don't like to be in a prison. Okay? The prophet doesn't like to be in a prison because of his da'wah and what he could do for Allah Azza wa Jal. Others maybe because of the fun they think they could have. So he told the one that was going, and he's going back to his old job again, being with the king, he said, قُرْنِي عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ. Remind, tell your king about me, and tell him my innocence and the top person I am. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَأَنْسَاهُ الشَّيْطَانُ ذِكْرَ رَبِّهِ. Because of that, Allah Azza wa Jal says, that the shaitan made the one that survived forget about everything that Yusuf told him. And then Allah says, فَلَبِثَ فِي السِّجْنِ بِضْعَ سِنِينَ. And Yusuf stayed in the prison, بِضْعَ سِنِينَ, 7 years, 8 years, 9 years. Yani look how long he stayed. Forgotten. And Yusuf may be having hopes that maybe now This man will mention me and the king will remember me and then he'll take me out at least, pull me through court, judge me. I'm thrown into prison without being convicted wrong or right. Being guilty or innocent. Ask about me. But the man forgot. The man forgot. Some scholars say that was a test for Yusuf alayhi salam. Why ask him to remind the king about you? Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Resort to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are some of the scholars saying. Until the right moment came for the king to meet with Yusuf alayhi salam, and for the one that Yusuf told him to remember, or to remind the king about him, to remember Yusuf alayhi salam. And this is a story, inshallah. We'll speak about next week how the king saw in his dream, an amazing dream, and no one could have interpreted that dream. And then the one that was filling up the cup of wine to the king remembered.